Do you have a face for a dark room? Do people tell you you're ugly? Have you ever looked in the mirror and it cracked? Have you ever been to the zoo and people throw peanuts and food at you? Well, let me tell you what. Why don't you check out Mark's Wrestling Masks on Facebook? That's MARC'S, Mark's Wrestling Masks on Facebook, because that's who keeps our ugly mugs covered too. Welcome to the Shiz Show with your hosts, Vader from Wish and NWO Machine. And NWO Cat.
I feel like I just woke up from a nap.
Did hell freeze over? What's going on here?
It must have frozen over. Well, we do live in a cold climate.
We do. Well, not this week.
No, well, not. Yeah, no kidding.
Apparently, climate crisis is actually kicking in now.
Yeah, you know, global warming, I don't mind it.
No.
I really don't. Yeah, right now, I don't mind it.
No.
If you're new to the show, which we are,
this feels like it.
Welcome to the Shiz Show, or welcome back to the
welcome
Shiz
back.
Show.
Yeah.
We've been busy, but we've had people asking for us to come back. I have no idea why. That
because you have a voice for this.
I definitely have a voice and a face for this.
No.
On here, and I definitely
very handsome.
I have a gut for the circus.
Ah.
And well, we're not going to get into that. So, like I said, I got all the pills saved up for January of next year.
Oh, jeez.
So tell me about yourself.
Oh, boy.
Who are you? For those
I'm Vader from Wish.
Yeah, you're Vader from
Twitter.
Wish. On the Twitter.
On the Twitter.
And I'm not on the Twitter.
I'm also BubbaFit52 on Instagram. So.
Are you?
Yeah, I've turned my Instagram back on. I figured out.
Oh, okay.
I've been kind of off social media pretty much, except for I was off Facebook for a bit, went back on.
Hey, if you're on Instagram, you might be able to find EJ.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the real EJ.
The real EJ, you're doing some detective work.
I did some. That's where I've been all this time. I've been very busy being a detective. And
not a creeper, a detective.
Yeah, a detective and finding out who the real EJ is.
Yeah, and you did.
And I did, which is funny because if you're on Twitter, it's EJ is on fire. 99 was the account that, you know, we had suspected that there were things with the account.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a guy on Twitter who was hell-bent on proving that she was a 10-year-old kid.
Yeah.
And I
think you disproved that.
And I did, yeah. And the funny part is I've always defended that particular account.
Yeah.
And, I did some detective work. And the person who ran the account, I'm not sure, but the person behind the photo is a legit person who's not underage.
Cool.
So we've
vindication for
we've
EJ.
We've solved the EJ mystery,
nice.
And hopefully whoever's behind it is okay.
Yes.
But, so I'm off Twitter, but I still have the, what do I have? Oh, TikTok.
You're on the TikTok.
I think I'm just NWO Machine on TikTok.
I think we still have the Welcome to the Shiz Show on Facebook. Bliss was running that for us.
Yeah, so. I'm off Facebook too.
Yeah.
So the last I saw on Facebook, he did put up a "we're closed" sign.
Yeah. We still keep getting active, like people following it and stuff. So
here we are.
So how are we going to be able to, where can people find this one, I guess? Well, I guess if they're listening to it, they obviously found it.
Yeah, you're on YouTube for sure.
YouTube.
We're going to put this on YouTube. No pictures. We'll just let it run. And a lot of people like to listen to podcasts through YouTube.
Yeah.
And I think that's the way to go to do. Maybe we'll get as big as, have you heard of Sam Sulek?
Oh, the bodybuilder?
Yeah.
Guy? Yeah.
Maybe we'll
impressive.
Yeah. No kidding. Yeah.
Young kid too. I think he's early 20s.
Like. I would say, I think he's 21.
Yeah.
And he's got the bodybuilding community by storm.
Yeah.
The funniest part was that, first of all, our show is about nothing.
No.
That's the whole thing about
I've been following a guy lately, speaking of bodybuilding. This guy, Tony, I think it's Tony McKelvery or something.
Yeah.
Calls himself the Big Bad Wolf.
Oh.
He's like a British guy or something. Hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
But he's got really good. He shows you like an exercise.
Yeah.
And he goes, quit wasting your time doing it this way. Instead of doing these stupid things, just do this and this. And he simplifies things. And I really like his presentation and everything. And
see, and that's the interesting thing. Have you watched a lot of Sam Sulek?
Not really. No, I don't. Because I'm not on TikTok.
So. He's YouTube.
Yeah. Oh, see, I don't really go on that, but I get the odd reel on like Facebook and stuff. Yeah, I've watched it. Yeah,
this guy every day, like for me and you, we're sitting here going, oh, for crying out loud, I got to upload this. It's going to take half an hour.
Yeah.
That's a half hour show. Yeah. This guy puts up 1 hour video shows a day.
Oh, wow.
And his TikTok.
That's probably his job, though. He's probably in.
Well, now, like, here's 20. He's full time school, university, and he's taken up this bodybuild. And the funny thing is, he's quite the character. Like, he's one of those guys. Talk about simplifying. Mm-hmm. He's gone, like, away from the science based lifting.
Okay.
Right. And he went back to the old school. That's the cool thing about him, to the Ronnie Coleman's and Kevin Lavroni's and all those guys.
Probably, what's that Meltzer guy? Not the wrestling one, but I like watching his videos.
Yeah. So he's simple. And he's funny because he talks like his biggest thing. You and I could definitely get into his bodybuilding diet when he's on a bulking.
Yeah.
He's eating 6 Krispy Kremes a day.
Oh, wow.
On his bulking phase.
Yeah, see, I can't do that right now. Well, we've been off. I found out that I have adult onset type 2 diabetes.
Oh, no.
Started on metformin, but
it's
working.
It's my working
sugars
okay.
I wasn't bad. Like, my sugars are like 10 to 11.
Yeah.
So it's that creeping up stage. So,
So
now I'm between 7 and 8.
Oh, just, good. See? Well, you'll drop some pounds.
Well, I have already, yeah.
There
I'm down to 340, which I weighed myself today. But the problem is, though, I'm afraid to eat anything because now I'm like, oh, I don't want my sugars to
spike.
Then I take the pill, and one of the big side effects of it is GI upset. So I got to take this twice a day. So twice a day, I get a little bout of IBS, which is great because I take my pill before I get to work. And by the time I get to work,
you're ready.
Bonjour, says my poop. But I got to work. So
yeah. And you know what? I hate, now we're really off topic. Moving from bodybuilding Sam Sulik to IBS now. But you know what? If you've never struggled with IBS, and I have too, I know your feeling. Like, and it's almost like it's like the dog. When they got to go, they're waiting at the door.
Oh, yeah.
Like, we got to go.
Quote Nestor Pister, heavy danger.
Yeah, it's like one of the guys at work, he says, emergency.
Yeah.
Points to his ass. But yeah, so this Sam Sulik, he talks about calories are calories. Mm-hmm. And it's quite interesting because he's trying to eat 45 to 5,000 a day. And he says, it doesn't matter. Like, and he's really proven the bodybuilding industry wrong in a lot of respects, where he's going, I eat all these Krispy Kremes.
Yeah.
It's 1,000 calories. He'll drink a jug of chocolate milk.
Yeah.
And he'll say, this is the jug of chocolate milk with the protein and the calories.
Yeah.
And I'm making my calories.
Yeah.
And he's ripped like a North End bus.
Well, like a lot of people like doing the amino acids. I've read a lot of reports saying you don't need them. Like, I got like a flavor. It's like a Southern sweet tea.
Yeah.
So it's very tasty, but is it really doing anything?
Who knows, I don't know. Man. So I got the BCAs in the water bottle. I don't even know what they stand for, but
I think that's what I meant to say. BCAs.
Same thing. I think so. Again, from my little past of like dabbling in the bodybuild to just trying to work out the BCAs. It's if we're working really hard and we're sweating it out, you need to replenish them.
Yeah,
and that's the whole trick. And the same thing, electrolytes and all that stuff. So that's part of the process. But if you're just a gym rat like me who goes in there and texts and does one sit up and goes home, I probably don't need the BCAs, but they taste good.
Save your money, kids.
Save it. So,
yeah.
Well, I'm glad you're still alive and okay.
Oh, same with you.
Well,
we both kind of fell out of touch with each other. So,
well, life happens.
Life happens. Yeah.
And, you know, I won't get into the shit storm that I'm still going through, but, yeah, whatever. The pills are being saved. So,
oh, come on.
So let's talk.
I still get your belts, though, right?
Yeah. The belts are yours.
Did you just get a new one?
Yeah, I did. And now, here's the thing. Because my life is in turmoil, I ordered from Capco.
Yeah.
And I ordered the Trios Scissor Me Daddy belt.
Oh, nice.
I had to. I had to do it.
It's a nice looking belt.
It's hysterical. It's so unique.
Right? I just like the end with the scissors.
and Scissor Me Daddy ass. So he's still one of my favorites.
Yeah.
And look, I even got the acclaimed water bottle today.
It looks like it, yeah.
So you can scissor me later. And
you're sitting on the acclaimed chair.
I'm on the acclaimed chair. Well, get Nurse Peach the cat.
Yeah. I had to kick her off the table.
Oops. Yeah, we got rid of her. She didn't want to do an interview, set up the mic, and she said no. But so I got the belt, and you still get my belts on January 12th next year.
Jeez.
So mark it down.
I don't want them.
Yeah. Well, someone's going to take them.
I'll take them if you're
interested. Yeah. I don't want them. Someone's going to take them. So let's talk about the Royal Ramble.
Yes.
And I'm going to say Ramble because we got treated to Pat McAfee.
Yeah. Oh, for.
Yeah. So he's
less rambling time than Michael Cole.
Yeah, I know.
Which they pointed out.
He's
but you know what? That women's one, that knocked it out of the park.
Okay.
That was awesome. That was everything about it was good. The only thing I didn't like was Maxine Dupri. She should not be in that ring. Like, she entered the ring with a botch and then had another couple botches. And I don't know. I don't know the moves she's doing. Like, no.
I think part of it is they're really trying to push her to learn a little bit. Yeah. So they give her as little time as possible. But if you look in the back, Sonya Deville is hurt.
Yeah.
There was another one who's hurt. Charlotte's hurt. Sorry. Yeah. They brought Becky Lynch in, which to me, I don't think they should have had her, but they needed her in there. Who else are you going to bring?
They brought Jordynne Grace in.
Yeah.
That was awesome. That was my highlight of the night.
And was dressed like a Slim Jim.
Yeah, she was. That's her new ring gear, though. Yeah. That's what she's been wearing. But that's a girl that's really, like, when she started, she was a heavier girl.
Yeah.
And she's really put in the, she's even competed in bodybuilding.
Yeah,
like, she's good. Like, she's wrestled. Or her husband is John Gresham, who's another TNA, NWA type guy. I just had a match, I think, with him recently, and it was a great match. I watched highlights online. She was good. That was my highlight of the Rumble, was her coming out. So I didn't expect that.
I have to say, where I was watching it, the guys and his kid turned to me, and they said, who's winning the female Rumble? And I said, Bayley.
Yeah.
And now I haven't really watched a lot of WWE lately,
no.
But I really wanted Bayley.
Yeah.
And I just think because of the garbage that I've seen with her and... You know,
it looks like they're setting up a little bit of a swerve with Damage Control that they're probably going to kick her out.
So that's the whole trick. So I think
because they're racist, she's not Japanese, and the rest of them are. So
that's right. Yeah. You can't wrestle and be
no.
You know. Mm-hmm. And actually, someone mentioned that today on one of the social media platforms. They said, they said the women's Rumble was quite black heavy.
Yeah.
And I thought about it, and I went, well, I don't really think so because, I think what they meant was that. Naomi came in, big pop, right?
Yeah,
like which.
Yeah, she's had a good career since she left. Like, her and Jordynne Grace just dropped that TNA belt to her recently. So. And TNA just redid all their belts too, and they're nice.
They're like, nice belts. Yeah. So I don't think Naomi's missed many meals since she's left. No. She looked
well. It all went to one part of her body.
Yeah, she definitely looked a little bit.
And she threw that around the ring like crazy.
She looked a little bigger, but so I guess they had Naomi, Cargill.
Yeah,
I'm glad they didn't put her over.
Yeah,
for that, let her get in.
I think she got hurt. I think when she took that shoulder bump, I think because she laid around for a while. Like,
yeah.
And she wasn't really selling it, it seemed like. Like, I was like, even my brother was watching with me, or he was not watching, we were like texting, and he's like, I think she just hurt herself. And I'm like, I think she took it a little too hard. I don't know, but.
I would have liked Tiffany Stratton in earlier.
Yeah.
I think, because to me, there's another one who probably could use more ring time in the big time. So I wish they would have given her just a little bit more ring time in there. But I'm glad she got in there.
Yeah.
And then,
And even Nia Jax.
She's lost weight.
Yeah, she lost a lot of weight. She looked good. Like, you know. But, I mean, when they put her in there, that would have been a perfect. Usually, that point in a Rumble-type match, the big heel comes in, cleans house.
Thank you.
And it thins the ring out a bit. And they didn't do that. And it made no sense.
No. As a matter of fact.
But they kept trying to sell. It took 11 broads to throw last time. But still, I think they should have cleaned it out a bit. And it's a nice reset. You get that point to the match where it's kind of a reset. Then you can do some spots.
Both. I think both Rumbles could have used a reset. Yeah. It didn't happen.
Even Omos, when he came in the men's, he could have done. He could have cleaned out some garbage and then made some space. But
take himself out if he doesn't mind. I couldn't believe they had him in there. There's so many guys in the back they could have used.
Oh, yeah.
But why him? I don't get it.
And what, the biggest surprise in the men's was Andrade? Which is okay, fine. I'm glad. But I thought him and Charlotte broke up. Like, So you bring her ex-husband in. You
know, like, did they, though?
I don't know. I thought I read somewhere they did. I don't know. I could care less. I don't know him. So. I mean, it was nice to see him back. Like, but really, I expected maybe someone else. Like, I didn't know who I was expecting.
For a big name. I really thought, because he's made one or two appearances, I thought The Rock might come in.
Yeah.
Then I thought to myself when I was mentioning it, I thought, well, if they bring The Rock in, how do you dispose of The Rock?
Yeah, you can't.
Right,
you bring him in, he's got to go.
He's got to go over, right? Which would have set up the Roman Reigns.
Yeah, and I think that still could happen. I could see it maybe being a three way or something.
Well, like, see, that's garbage. You and I have talked about this before. That this fatal four way was just shit.
It was stupid.
Like,
it made no sense.
None.
And it was so pretty. Oh, big surprise! Solo comes in and interferes. Like, I've seen this already 500 times.
I know.
The guy wrestles 4 times a year. And he has the same kind of match, like, every single time.
And it's rest periods. Like, and you and I have mentioned this, too. He's got
3 moves.
He's got
3. And a botch.
I give him, you know, I think he's got 5 moves now.
He's progressed.
Plus,
that's why.
Plus the botch.
Plus the botch.
Yeah. So 6.
But I just think it's a big slap in the face that he's now had the belt almost as long as Hogan.
Yeah.
You know, like, I think he's beat Bruno's first run. Like,
yeah.
And these are legit, like,
I know,
fighting champions that defended it regularly. And four or five times. That's what I was going
to
say.
Like, every 30, back in the day.
Yeah, it was 30 days.
Everybody seems to go back to that 30 days. I don't know if that stipulation's still been in there.
No.
They obviously had to take it out. But
yeah.
If you think he's already gone through another pay-per-view without defending it.
Yeah.
So yeah. He's not even on the cards.
And he won't be on the next one. He won't be on Elimination Chamber. No. We won't see him till WrestleMania.
Yeah. So what's the point? Like, it's such a garbage record that it makes no sense.
Yeah.
You might as well say, all right, Vader, listen, I'm giving you the acclaimed water bottle as the acclaimed water bottle champion.
Nice.
But you got to drink 10 of these a day. But I don't see you for the next 3 months.
Yeah.
And go, did you drink every day?
I had 12.
And that's Roman Reigns' reign. We don't see him. They just keep racking up the days.
Yeah.
Because he's never around.
Like, I wonder how active he is on house shows. He's probably not.
So. Well, even still, like, I don't.
But I mean, TV, you know, like Seth Rollins, he's always defending it. Like,
I know. You know. And that's the other thing too, right? Yeah. Like, so I think
that's what they're kind of doing though. I think they did that on purpose to just kind of.
Yeah, because one guy's not defending it. Yeah. So they need, and I'll bet you Rollins is in there going, okay, this is stupid.
Yeah.
Like, fine. You want to run him around for the next 6.5 years with a belt. Well, everyone else is in the back. I'm sure someone went to Triple H and said, enough.
Yeah, probably like, not. Well, now he's running the show because Vince is completely out. Have you read much about
Speaking
that?
Speaking of a shiz show.
Like, I was reading, the latest I read was apparently he had different dildos and he named them after wrestlers. And he had like a big black one that was Bobby Lashley.
Oh, my.
He had a clear one that was John Cena because you can't see it. There was one that was supposed to like, really wide on top and narrow, and he called that Kurt Angle because of his big head. So, you know, and as I'm reading this stuff, and I'm just like, wow. So apparently this girl that had this, that he paid the sexual assault money to, has come out with the details. So, you know.
What happened to hush money?
Yeah, I don't know what, but now there's details out. So I guess he's got the Bobby Lashley. He's like, oh, do you like Bobby Lashley? You know, like it's disturbing, really. Like, you know.
You know what?
And suppose there's something, there's rumors about Brock Lesnar being, that's why he wasn't in the Rumble. I read that either Pat McAfee or Braun Breaker were took Lesnar's spot.
So, okay.
And I'm hoping it's not Braun, because then that means that Brock would have got thrown out by Dominic, which makes no sense.
Yeah, not necessarily. I think they probably would have changed it. But that's, and McAfee was, even the crowd was like,
he wasn't even dressed. He's wearing cowboy boots. You can't work in that. Like, you rip up the ring. Like,
at least he had sleeves on for those strings.
It was kind of a funny spot how he kind of like, and then he climbed out. I'm done. But it was funny. One thing he said when he's talking about how big Omos was, he's like, how big is that thing in there? Like, and I was like, whoa.
Well, maybe he wasn't talking about Omos.
Yeah.
No, maybe
it was Omos.
Maybe he was checking other things out.
Probably.
Maybe he was checking
the thing on Omos. Yeah. Like, who knows?
I wonder what Vince called that one.
Well, another thing, I guess Ronda Rousey tweeted that as long as Bruce Pritchard is around, Vince McMahon is still running things. Because when he left before, Bruce Pritchard was apparently doing everything for him. So if he's still around, then Vince will still have...
I don't even know who's around.
Yeah. Well, now that they merged with UFC, that TKO thing.
And I think...
I'd like to read more, but on the other hand, I kind of don't because it just sounds like it's just horrible. But,
I don't know. Like, I'm almost done with the Vince McMahon.
Yeah. Like, it's time.
Because it's one of those... You know what? Here we go again.
Yeah.
It's going to be hush money. It's going to be dropped. It's going to be whatevered. It's almost like a Peter Nygaard situation here.
Well, he's getting charged with sex trafficking.
Vince?
Sex trafficking and sexual assault or something. Like, it's pretty, if those charges go through, it's,
what's he going to do?
Yeah.
Well, and then there was a rumble, here we go, a slight rumbling that the falling out between Shane and Vince was because of all this stuff.
Oh, maybe,
prior
that makes
to,
sense. Yeah.
He wanted nothing to do with being involved with his dad because of all the allegations going on. Mm-hmm. And Shane said, I'm out.
Yeah,
I don't want to be part of this. Yeah. So I wonder if Stephanie had the same same situation. But sure, this is the first time in history there's no McMahons involved in WWE.
Yeah.
They're all gone.
Yeah.
Except for Triple H, which I'm sure still takes some orders from Vince.
Oh, yeah.
At some point. So, yeah. So I'm going to say that the card stealer for sure, like you said, was the women's match.
Yeah, it was great.
And the Fatal 4-Way was...
garbage.
Was terrible.
The Logan Paul match was decent. Like, they put on an okay show, so...
I did like the end.
Yeah.
I kind of like the end where, like, you don't think Kevin Owens was going to get busted
yeah.
for having Nux, but yeah. he did.
Yeah.
So to me, but again, now we have another part-time champion.
Yeah.
When do we see Logan Paul? We haven't seen him since he won.
No.
So, yeah. like, he's like him and Roman Reigns are sitting on yeah. the island of like, yeah. relaxing.
Yeah.
Of non-relevancy. So, yeah, and then that one was, and then.
Men's. And I kind of thought that he was going to drop the belt. I thought yeah. maybe it was, you know, because they had just, Austin Theory brought some legitimacy back to a belt.
Sure.
Like yeah. Gunther has with the Intercontinental one.
Yeah. So, yeah. See, I actually thought that at first, I thought, you know what, maybe Gunther will go over.
Mm-hmm.
And then I thought, well, he's still a heel, even though yeah. the people love him.
Yeah.
They do love him. They love the heel, but I thought that would be almost like the Hogan Warrior where
yeah,
Intercontinental exactly. versus champion
yeah.
and the Intercontinental gets vacated because yeah. Gunther takes it from
yeah.
Roman Reigns, which I think people would accept heel yeah. on heel at that
point. Oh, yeah.
yeah. Yeah. If he did it. And, of course, we get...
Yeah. Dusty's kid again.
Yeah. Two AEW guys.
Yeah.
Are in yeah. WWE's yeah. final two.
Yeah, which is sad.
It's terrible.
Unnecessary.
Like, totally. Like, again, if I was the WWE roster guys, I'd be like, we've been sitting here,
mm-hmm.
and you're going to put those two guys in for
the look final? At all the work Drew McIntyre's done in the past few years.
I know.
That guy's earned it.
He's earned a lot.
Yeah.
yeah he and looks good now. He
continually gets pooped on.
Like, yeah. I don't know why. And yeah. gosh knows where Baron Corbin went.
Yeah. Well, he's NXT now.
Which to me doesn't make
coming
sense
coming out
with
again. A stupid wolf. Yeah. Hood on or some stupid thing.
Like, I haven't really watched a lot of NXT. Yeah,
I catch it every now and then. Yeah. It's hard to watch. Like the vignette, it's overacting in the vignette. I see they're trying to figure it out.
And, yeah.
But I don't know. It's
you know who I feel sorry for is the Viking Raiders.
Yeah.
Like Ivar is just on his own.
Yeah. Well, the other guy's injured.
Yeah. And I feel because they were a good tag team. Yeah. What do you do with them?
Yeah.
Right. But man.
Well, the tag. But like they've made the tag team pretty much irrelevant. Like they got both belts on the same guys still.
Yeah.
And they hardly defend it. Like.
But yeah. Well, they're supposed to do it on a Monday Night Raw.
Tomorrow. Monday
which
night.
Which would be we're taping here on a Sunday.
Yeah.
So it would be tomorrow. So by the time we get to the next show,
I can't remember who they're
fight DYI.
Oh, big.
Or yeah. DIY, yeah, whatever
they're called. Yeah, they're not dropping those belts.
Yeah, they're, again, another useless tag team.
Split them up. There's no reason for them to have both. Like, actually, I'd like to see just one heavyweight champion, one set of tag team.
Back in the old days.
Have the U.S., you have the Intercontinental, that's it, you know.
And to be honest with you, I think that the way that Austin Theory and,
Grayson Waller.
Grayson Waller.
Yeah.
He's hysterical.
Yeah, like, they're great.
He has become, Grayson Waller to me has
become. A-Town down under there.
Yeah. And they would be good to have the tag belts.
They would be.
Yeah. Because like some of the bumps that they were taking were hysterical. Right?
And they're great on the mic. Like even that pre-interview they did where Grayson Waller talks about accidentally throwing Austin Theory out. And they're like, what? Like they got great chemistry. Like,
they do.
Yeah. I like that. I didn't really care for Grayson Waller that much on his own. I thought he was annoying.
Yeah.
But with Austin Theory, they're great.
They're magic. Yeah. It's one of those. Yeah. You don't want to split them up.
Yeah. They found something that works so good. And it's too bad because Austin Theory on his own, like a couple years, he should be. He should be in the heavy. He should have the big strap.
So. He should. Yeah. He looks good.
Yeah.
He's
great in the ring. Like never see him screw anything up that I can recall. Like, you know,
and he takes he's the comical bump.
Yeah.
Right. To me.
Yeah. Like when he took the stunner last year.
Like
that was almost the only one that took it better was Scott Hall.
Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah. And I think it was Grayson Waller who kept getting guys landing on him. Was it this Rumble? Who kept getting guys thrown on top of him?
I think it might have been him.
I think it was well. And again, he's just comedy, right? Yeah. And that's sort of.
But he's a good worker.
He is a good worker too. And I've become. I wasn't a big fan of NXT when he came up. I'm like, okay, what's this Grayson Waller effect garbage here?
Yeah.
But the more like he's worked on his craft.
Yeah.
And that's what we've said long ago.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it has nothing to do with the wrestling.
No.
It's all character, right?
Yeah.
Like when you think
and he's developed it
great.
Like and it's not at a point where it's stale.
Yeah.
I think he's gonna keep developing.
He'll keep
it's just
going.
Gonna get better and
here's another guy. It's no secret. And although I got along good with him, Honky Tonk Man.
Yeah.
Terrible wrestler.
Yeah.
Character was unbelievable, which is why he carried that for as long as he did.
Well, he's a good basic wrestler. You weren't going to get anything fancy out of him. He could do the basic stuff.
There was no top rope from the Honky Tonk Man. No, none of that stuff going on. Look at this. I have no idea where we are on this.
Oh, boy. Oh, is it still recording?
Oh, yeah. We're almost at the end here.
Oh, come on. No, we're going to go a little longer.
Oh, that means more work for me. First time back. Who knows what this is going to sound like?
You'll be fine.
Yeah?
You're not going to lose it. You're a trained professional. Highly trained professional.
Speaking of highly.
Yeah.
I've actually tried marijuana.
Oh, wow.
Well, the sleeping marijuana.
Yeah.
I don't know what that's called.
Oh, those edible things or whatever?
No, no. This is you take a puff or a couple puffs before bed.
Oh, nice.
And
well, it is legal. So.
I know it's legal now, but I not that I wasn't an advocate for it. I thought, well, I don't know if it's really going to do anything.
Yeah.
And when I was younger, I remember smoking up and my mouth was all cotton balls and blah, 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 and really didn't do anything for me.
Yeah.
So I went and I bought this, I don't know, some kind of vape pen with fancy stuff in it. And I took a couple puffs a couple times and I'm sitting there and I'm like, I don't think it does anything. Yeah. I still don't think it does anything.
No. And you had a nice conversation with NWO Cat. And
yeah, he's been good. Yeah, he's,
and you're like, ooh, I think it is doing something.
Yeah. It's well, you know, come to think of it, I do chase the laser pointer with him when I get stoned. So, I've tried it.
Yeah. I still haven't. I've just, I've never been, never done it. I don't know. Now it's legal. I'm like, yeah. My brother gave me, because I know sometimes I don't sleep great. So my brother gave me some edibles and I'm just like, I'm afraid to try them. I don't know what they're going to do.
Well,
I got to get up early for work too. So I want to take one and then sleep through my alarm.
You know, you won't do that. Yeah. I don't think that, again, mind you, it doesn't affect me. I literally take a couple of puffs. Yeah. I go lie down and I'm waiting. Maybe that's the problem.
That's the problem. You're like, when's this going to kick in?
When's it going to kick in? I'm not tired yet. Yeah. And I just think it just.
Or you're not taking enough.
Or maybe that's it. Maybe I need a stronger strain.
Cheech and Chong size. or a Ricky from Trailer Park Boys 6 paper joint version.
Close the door in the bedroom, puff away, me and the cat out cold till Thursday kind of thing. But yeah, I'm not sure if anyone wants to contact us, please feel free to do so. I don't know how, but and tell us, you know, if we're doing something wrong with the weed. I don't know how you not.
Well, you know what? You don't end up like that movie Reefer Madness.
I've never seen it.
Oh.
Is it good?
I've never watched it. It looks stupid. It's like, I think it's like from the 50s.
Oh, well, so then it's got to be dumb for sure.
I think it's about kids doing the reefer and then going crazy and doing fancy dancing, probably. I don't know, but yeah.
So. I have no idea about, hey, you know, speaking of fancy dancing.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Come on. Oh. Just like old times. Okay.
There you go.
All right. I'll make you stop now.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah,
stop now. Usually we do that at the end, though.
Well, we are at the end. We're kind of at the end. So
we're wrapping it up, I guess.
We got to wrap here. We got a 30-minute. I still have to upload this. I have to figure out how I did it before.
But anyway, Rumble, Women's Rumble was great. The rest of it was meh.
Out of 10, what do you give the Women's Rumble?
9.5.
Yeah,
easily.
You're going out
high. It kept me.
Yeah.
Like the whole night, I'm like, I got to go to bed. And I ended up staying up. And then I ended up staying up for the men's just to see who was good. And I was so disappointed.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, I was shocked you were still chirping at me when we did. But yeah,
I was going to go. I had every intention of going to bed. And then I just like, okay.
I'm giving it an 8. Yeah. And the reason I give it an 8 was for just what you and I talked about earlier. They had a chance to clean house and do a reset with Nia Jax. They didn't. I think there's some of the things they could have done a little bit better for that.
But compared to the men's, that's why I'm giving it that compared to the men's, because the men's was whatever.
I think 8's pretty darn good.
Yeah, no, 8's good.
8 and 9 is good. So next match in was the Roman Reigns fatal 4-way.
I give that a 3, like whatever.
I'm going with a 4 on at best.
Yeah.
And
that's a generous 3.
All right. And then we have the Logan Paul match.
Yeah, 7, 6, yeah, 7. Yeah,
I've been there, okay. 6.5, 7 in that range. And the men's Rumble, I'm just going to throw it at a 5.
Yeah.
I wasn't impressed any way or shape or form through
the whole
ending
thing. Was dumb. Like it's like you knew that was going to happen. It was going to be him or Punk. And
well, because we heard about it, like he still has to finish the story.
They both have to finish this.
So. This is Dusty Rhodes country. This is blah, blah, blah country.
And then Punk, and I don't think Punk's ever won the Rumble.
No.
So that's why, he's got it, you know. So that'll be next year.
Yeah. And then to have two AEWites as their finals, to me, just didn't say the right thing.
No.
Vader, where can we find you on? Do you even know your Twitter handle anymore?
It's @VaderFromWish.
Okay,
I just turned my Twitter back on.
I was awful.
Yeah. It was just rage farming every time I went on there. Just Canadian politics and
stuff.
So it still is, but I just don't. I just kind of scroll through.
You know what? I kind of feel bad because I thought, well, They say you have 30 days to re-sign into your account.
Yeah.
And maybe I should have just somehow kept it active. But it's gone. Twitter is gone for me. There's 7,500 people, sayonara. But again, I just found no one was interacting anymore since it went to the X.
Yeah.
A lot of it changed.
Yeah. I wasn't seeing the same posts from like somewhere, the regular people I used to always see, like, you know, like Bama Girl, like hardly ever. Like, most of the people we interacted with, I don't know, wasn't getting them.
So. No, I don't know where.
And I know they're, if I looked for on their profile, they're active, but.
And the other
and
thing.
And I don't think they blocked me.
I don't know. No, I wouldn't say so because they like you, but I think, and the other thing too, I've noticed on X now is that every third person tweeting is, well, either a female saying, oh, is your dick hard because I'm naked standing here tweeting, right? Like, or, which gets 500 likes, right, in 3 minutes. Or you get the people with the pictures of four different things on there going, ketchup's not available. What do you put on your wiener?
Yeah.
Right? And I'm like, that's all it's become is that stuff. So to me, and hatred, a lot of hatred out there too. And Trump 2024.
That's right.
I think he's going to do it.
I hope so.
I think he is. I really think
I'm more curious what's going to happen up here in Canada. Well, like they're already trying to change the rules. Apparently they got a bill coming in where they're calling it like voter reform, but it's because like the two other parties, everything's tanking for them. So they're doing their best to.
That idiot Trudeau has ruined everything in Canada. So anyway, that's enough of this shiz.
Yeah.
We'll catch you again soon.
Oh, yeah, for sure we will. This was fun. I really missed this.
Vader, so. I got to say, I had a lot of fun, and it's good seeing you again.
Yeah, same.
And everybody out there, thanks for checking us out.
And what are they supposed to do?
Oh, until next time.
Keep kicking out. There you go.
Bye, everyone. Bye-bye.